Today's tutorial is on using JAWS screen reader with Microsoft Excel. If you are a disability support specialist, you may be called upon to train blind or visually impaired students on how to use JAWS with Excel. There are a couple of common ways to start JAWS, which we demonstrate in this lesson.
Outline of instruction lesson 1, starting JAWS and Excel. Lesson 2, creating and saving a workbook. Lesson 3, navigation of menus and worksheets. Lesson 4, data entry and formatting. Lesson 5, creating charts or graphs. Lesson 6, formulas and data references. Lesson 7, printing and exiting.
Lesson 1, starting JAWS in Excel. In this lesson, you will learn how to save a workbook and create additional sheets inside it. Use the Windows key on the keyboard. Then begin typing the first letter of the words JAWS. Press Enter. This should start JAWS.
JAWS Professional. Using JAWS with Excel Basics-PowerPoint.
Press the Control key to make it be quiet. Then press the Windows key again.
Search box edit. Type in text.
Excel.
Excel app.
Press Enter.
Enter. Opening Excel. Please wait. Excel backstage view.
When you get to this screen, it will be set to start a blank workbook. Press Enter.
Enter. Book 1.
And that is how you get JAWS and Excel to work together to start a workbook. You have another way to start JAWS in Excel, and you probably would want your students to know how to do this as well. There are shortcuts here on my desktop for both JAWS and Excel. If you right-click on one of the shortcuts, go to Properties, and then find the shortcut key. You can then click the field None, and then enter a keystroke. I'm going to use Control Alt and J, which is the common keystroke for the shortcut for JAWS. Then click Apply. You'll have to have permissions to do this. I do, as I am an administrator of this computer. If you're not an administrator of the computer and you want this to be set up, you're going to have to get someone from your IT department to help. Once you finish and you have administration rights, you click OK. And then you can do the same thing for Excel. Right-click, Properties, click on Shortcut Key Field, press Control-Alt-E or whatever you choose, and then click Apply, then OK.